007, triple X.
Paul, what do you think you're doing?
Keeping the British end up, sir.
Nobody does me better. Makes me feel sad for the rest. Nobody does it half as good as you, baby. You're the best.
Good evening to the British James Bond fan club. And I am so grateful to all of you for keeping the British end up, and especially grateful to Philip, my friend, my little brother, and to his wife Emmeline that helped him to create this in the country where it all started. I know that you're gonna have a wonderful evening, and I'm very jealous. And I am very envious. But, oh, by the way, I'm Luciana Paluzzi, Fiona Volpe, Thunderball. Cheers. Love you all.
Cheers.
So thank you must be said to all of our club members, sponsors, donors, and brand partners who've been so generous in donating time and also lots that you'll all be able to bid on later. And a special thank you as well to Eubanks for donating their services, which means by getting rid of the seller's fees, buyer's fees, we're raising the most amount of money possible for UNICEF, which is what it's all about. Now, he's not gonna like me for doing this, but I'm going to do it anyway. without one man, tonight truly would not be possible. Now, we as a collective board look for guidance, and it comes in the form of our club president, Mr. Philip Dewhurst. And it is not an exaggeration to say that this man, our club president, has, I don't even know how to sum it up, he has gone above and beyond to pull tonight together, investing so much of his own time, money, effort, working with the brands, plugging away, making sure that we had the best time possible tonight and the most fabulous auction items that you're going to be able to bid on. I'm going to keep saying that. But truly, and from the heart, I must say a massive thank you personally to Philip, Phil, for his friendship, for his guidance, for his support, and for everything he has done, continues to do, and long may he continue to do for the Bond community, for the club, and for keeping the British end up. So please join me, because I like a drink as much as the next man, unless the next man is Philip Dewhurst. I know, invite Phil to make his very own today.
That was very nice. I didn't prepare anything. Not because I'm not a prepared individual, I am a prepared individual. Ask the boy team. I'm constantly on at them more than Simon is with the emails. But I didn't prepare anything because I wanted the weight and the emotion of the moment to decide and dictate what I was going to say to you all. And I'm going to be perfectly honest with you, looking at you all, I'm struggling for words, which is not very usual for me because I always have things to say. The first thing I want to say is that I could not have done this without my wife, Emily. You've tolerated just about everything you can get from me. I mean, she's an aerospace engineer. She's a very qualified individual, and she's been asked to do very strange tasks. And then when I'm not communicating what they are supposed to be properly, because I'm in a rush, she's kind of frustrated, and I thank you so much for everything you've done. The next bunch of people I would like to thank is the board team. That some knew me, some didn't, but I gave you a vision, and I said what I thought we should do. You perfected it, and we've worked on it together, and I love you all. And thank you to every single one of you, because you really have made all the difference. The next wonderful group are all of the Bond alumni that are here tonight to celebrate with us, to raise money for charity, to be with all of us, not because they're paid, but because their hearts are huge and they are here with us as family, as friends. So I thank all of you. I can't list you all because there's so many of you, but I love you all and thank you for believing in the club and believing in UNICEF and the vision and what we were doing. So I couldn't have done it without you again. Thank you. Very quick mention to my parents because I absolutely think they're fantastic and without them I really wouldn't have been here. But, and maybe that would have been better for some, but John, Mr. John Glen. When I started this club and I said to the board members, I would like to give you a Lifetime Achievement Award. I know you've had those before, but I wanted something from the British club. Because you are British, you're an institution, you are a visionary, you're wonderful, and you did pigeons before John Woo did. So, thank you. And I hope you're feeling the love in this room. And you can't cry, because I already have, so you have to keep it together. Right. I don't want to rattle on too much, but what I will say now, it's time for another video. Is that right, Mark?
Yes.
I've completely forgotten.
That is correct.
So there are friends that couldn't be here tonight, John, and I'd like to just pay attention to the screen. There's a few people that just wanted to say a few words for you.
Hi, John. How are you? This is Lynn Holly. I hope you remember me. It was a few decades ago, but boy, this is a wonderful event to honor you, the director extraordinaire. I loved working with you. You were so patient, you were so serious, and I could just see how each step you were able to put the puzzle together. And that's because you were this wonderful editor too. Well, you have created beautiful movies for thousands of people have loved all your work, and I'm honored to have worked with you. Take care, John. I wish I could be at your event. Sail on, everybody.
Hello, John. Kabir Bedi here, sending you greetings all the way from India. Congratulations on winning the Lifetime Achievement Award for all the wonderful work you've done. But I want to take this opportunity to thank you for making me the first Indian actor to be cast in a James Bond film. It was also the first James Bond film that was shot in India. So you can imagine my feeling when we were shooting at this wonderful Lake Palace Hotel, surrounded by the beauty of Udaipur, with Roger Moore and Maud Adams on my left, you directing me behind the camera, Barbara Broccoli and Michael Wilson on my right, the Bond girls all around us. And I felt absolutely euphoric. It was as if I'd died and gone to heaven. It was a very special moment for me. I thank you for that. And I thank you for all the wonderful guidance you gave me during the making of Octopussy. I thank the president of the British James Bond Fan Club, Philip Dewhurst, for organizing this wonderful event. And congratulations to you for winning this Lifetime Achievement Award. And from me, I present you my Lifetime Gratitude Award. Thank you, John.
Hi, John. Congratulations. I am so delighted that you are receiving a Lifetime Achievement Award. It's well deserved. I loved working with you in Shanty and in Pinewood Studios all those years ago. But I truly want to thank you from the bottom of my heart, John, because you were the very first director to give me my first acting role. So without you, I don't know if anything would have happened. So thank you from the bottom of my heart. I also want to say congratulations to the British James Bond Fan Club for raising money for UNICEF. I wish I could have been there with you all. I'm wishing you all the very best. I hope you have a fabulous night. And I am sending a kiss to the three Phils. Take care. Have great fun. Bye.
Congratulations for getting this award. You deserve it all. Going down memory lane, look, I'm just about to get ready to go into my favourite car and escape and with Bond, wherever he is. But I wanted to say what amazing time it was to film on the Living Daylights with you. We really, really had good fun, hard work. You were great to work with. And I loved working with you every time we worked together, and you brought me back on your other projects, TV. And I'm so, so thrilled that you are getting celebrated with this award. You deserve it. And bless you and Janine. And off I go with my favorite car, the Aston Martin, the Living Daylights. Bye.
John Glen. You have made me and all those fellow artisans like myself a part of a legacy that will no doubt move into the future, inspired by the work you've contributed to the longest running film series in history. I want to thank you for welcoming me into this franchise. Cubby Broccoli, Barbara Broccoli, and you, Mr. Glen, have given me cinematic immortality. And for that, sir, I thank you. My sincere congratulations.
Philip, president of 007GB, the British James Bond fan club, has asked me to congratulate director John Glen for getting the Lifetime Achievement Award on board HMS Belfast and raising money for UNICEF in memory of my Bond, Roger Moore. Thank you, John.
We do have someone that might be getting a Lifetime Achievement Award from the British Club. So, but before I bring John up, let's just take a look at a lifetime of achievement and work.
H-42, sir. 12 years in the Black Watch, rank of sergeant.
Blake, Jesse.
Donaldson, sir.
Whitty, Arthur, sir. H-43, medical orderly.
The countdown has started.
Go. You're only supposed to blow the bloody doors off.
Thank you.
you'll hit the rush hour.
Since then.
Thank you.
John Glen.
Truly, my friend, truly, nobody does it better. Responsible for a fifth of the franchise, and only the biggest.
Please accept this.
Accept this on behalf of all of our members and enjoy it. It's heavy. Careful.
It's weighty.
Rather weighty. Of course you can. It's your day.
Would you like me to hold that, or do you want to keep holding it?
It's nice.
Well, thank you very much, everyone. Particularly to Philip and his wonderful team and his family who have supported this event. I can't tell you how I'm a little bit overcome by this because I did have a very, very long career and I loved every moment of it. I can't think of a time when I didn't really enjoy it. And anyone who can say after being in the business for 60 odd years that you just enjoy it every day, I would go to work. I think my own family probably suffered a lot because I was away abroad all the time doing daring things with other people's lives, probably. I hope I could never kill anyone. I came close to it. But it was a wonderful experience. And without you folks, the fans, the people who supported those films, some are not as good as others, we know that. Roger Moore was my own favourite because he was such a nice man. And some people even like George Lanz Blazerby. You'll always find his fans.
I'm the only one.
That's right, well, you worked with him, didn't you? So you should know. Yeah. But of course, we can't forget Sean Connery, who really started the whole thing off. And,
thank you.